Welcome to XM.com for today's daily market comment by Mario Sagiriakos. I'm Christina Marujos. The European virus situation is getting worse by the day, with a surge in new cases and hospitalizations across the continent forcing many nations to go back into partial lockdown. The Netherlands announced it will shut down cafes, bars, and restaurants. There is chatter that French President Macron could announce a national curfew later today, and UK opposition leader Keir Starmer is calling for a circuit breaker shutdown of England. This is likely to derail the already fragile economic recovery, spelling bad news for fourth quarter growth and putting the prospect of a double-dip recession on the map. The real fear is that this time, governments might not roll out the heavy stimulus guns, which threatens to leave permanent scars on many of the worst impacted sectors and unemployment more broadly. Both the euro and sterling came under fire on Tuesday, with a defensive dollar and yen capitalizing most on their troubles. It was a similar risk-off story in the equity market, where the S&P 500 closed 0.6% lower, discouraged by the lack of progress in the U.S. stimulus talks. Rubbing salt into the wound was news that another late-stage vaccine trial has been put on halt, this time from pharmaceutical firm Eli Lilly. In the big picture, the global economic situation has deteriorated dramatically over the past few weeks, but markets have not paid much attention yet. Europe is on the verge of new lockdowns, but is unlikely to get the stimulus antidote to offset that pain. The prospect of a successful vaccine in the next month seems less likely, and US relief talks are going nowhere fast. Perhaps markets are taking solace in the rising chances of a decisive Biden victory that could bring huge stimulus with it. Even on that subject, though, the worst-case scenario for markets may be Biden winning the White House but Republicans keeping the Senate, setting the stage for persistent political gridlock. The bottom line is that equity markets have been priced for perfection and look vulnerable here. The joker in all this is, of course, the US election, which may overshadow everything else over the next 3 weeks. This was the Daily Market Comment. Thanks for watching at XM.com.